Hi, welcome to Jamf and Google, better than ever. My name is Alex Bauer. I'm a Chrome customer engineer. I work with various enterprises and I help with Chrome adoption. I help with any sort of technical challenges that enterprises have when it comes with integrating Chrome in their environment and configuring it and managing it. And so today we're going to talk a little bit more about the integration between Jamf and Chrome. I'm going to pause here for a second for you to review our forward-looking statement, and you can also screenshot it if you need to, and you can also find it under the resources section. Awesome. So Jamf is virtually the universal platform for all enterprise management in the Apple ecosystem. We know that users and admins really enjoy the experience they get from Chrome. And so we work together with Jamf to improve the overall experience even more. Today, we're going to talk about Jamf and Chrome on Mac. Then we're going to talk a little bit more on Jamf and Chrome on iOS, a little bit of a roadmap for Chrome, and a little discussion in Chrome extensions. So let's talk a little bit about Jamf and Chrome on Mac. So we listened to some of the challenges that administrators have voiced that they had with Chrome on Mac OS. And so based on some of that feedback we got from Jamf as well, we have diversified the package formats that we're offering for Chrome on Mac. Since version 80 of Chrome, we started offering a PKG file. That PKG file should allow for a much simpler deployment through Jamf Pro, as the admins don't have to go through the Jamf Composer workflow, and it should be just a pretty straightforward deployment. We also created a support article that covers how to deploy and configure Google update policies and push those onto your macOS machines. We are in the process of overhauling the overall Google update experience on macOS, and that should be coming out in the near future, sometime around next year, hopefully. And that would bring it in alignment with all of our other platforms. That should offer a much, much better experience for administrators. We do have a lot of policies that administrators really like to use when it comes to configuring Chrome on Mac OS, such as like homepage location, extension settings, manage bookmarks, and safe browsing, and things like that. All of those are available on our Chrome Enterprise policy page. And we've worked with Jamf on an integration between our cloud management console for Chrome browser and Jamf Pro, where it's easier to deploy those policies or those configurations onto those Chrome macOS machines. On our roadmap, we are looking at offering a side-by-side installation of Chrome browser on macOS. So that should allow administrators to run simultaneously a beta channel and a stable channel of Chrome. Previously, you would have to use one channel or the other, and you couldn't switch back and forth easily. You would have to reinstall the application. So now we're working on releasing that very, very shortly, where you'd be able to run multiple installations. So from policy deployment, we offer now multiple ways that you can configure the policies for Chrome browser and on macOS. You can configure the policies through Manage Preferences in Jamf Pro. And we also have our integration with our cloud management console, where the token is deployed via Jamf Pro. And you can follow the link in from the support article that kind of talks about how that is done. And that should provide a quick couple clicks experience for the admins to just get the browser managed by our console, and then the console allows you for a much easier configuration or a build out of policies that you will deploy on your browsers. Next up is Jamf and Chrome on iOS. So some of the things we've worked on improving the experience for administrators on iOS are related to app config. We've listened to the users and administrators that around the whole app config deployment, and we are planning to offer app config support for iOS Chrome, and that should allow for a subset of policies in early preview coming up soon And then in the future, we're looking at adding full CDCM integration or cloud management integration, and adding more policies to bring it to parity with the other desktop platforms sometime around 2021. But an early preview is coming out in the next few months, where we'll offer a few of the key or the most requested policies that administrators have been telling us about. Here's an example of an app config deployment or a package for Chrome on iOS. It's nothing that administrators are not familiar with. We're gonna offer documentation on all of the supported policies and everything. And from there, you can use the app config generator, build your package and deploy it through Jamf Chrome. So it should be, once again, a much better experience for the users on the iOS platform now as well. Related to Chrome extensions, a lot of users use extensions to enhance their overall experience in Chrome or add additional capabilities to the browser that by default Chrome doesn't offer. And so we've added a lot of changes on this chapter as well. Some of the things we're doing is we're planning to show more information in our cloud management console related to permissions, ownership, and version distribution related to extensions. And some of the other changes that we've done are related to policy changes, where we're continuing to invest in the safety of the Chrome Web Store. So, for example, we recently updated the Chrome Web Store spam policy to cover repetitive content. So duplicate extensions that provide the exact same experience for users. So we try to kind of limit that, as well as we've offered partial rollout and deferred publishing related to extensions, so you can slowly ramp up the rollout of a new version of an extension to your users. Some other upcoming changes are related to support for Manifest V3 extensions, which is coming around Q4 of 2020. We expect to offer the availability to support a Manifest V3 extension in the store, as well as more end user controls over the extension data access and what data the extension can access around for users, privacy data and so forth. As well as for Chrome Browser Cloud Management Console, we plan to offer an application extension usage report that gives you a lot more data around extensions. We are also planning to offer an extension workflow, which allows your users to request an extension, whether to be able to install it in their environment, and then you as an admin have the capability to approve it or deny it and so forth. We're also adding a lot more enhancements around the security aspect for extensions, and as well as for any feature that we're adding in our Chrome Browser Management Console, we are adding APIs, which would allow administrators to do some really cool integrations with products such as like ServiceNow or whatever, where any requests that come in on our console using the APIs, right, ServiceNow could detect those new requests and so forth. You can take a look at our support article that talks a little bit more about any sort of these changes, and that is linked below. So in the Chrome roadmap, what else is coming out down the pipeline for us that would help the overall Apple ecosystem? So as you're very familiar, Apple has announced their desire to shift away from Intel processors to ARM in their platform. And we do plan to offer ARM-based PKG and DMG packages somewhere around the Q4 of this year. So we do want to offer as close to day one support as possible to that. We are, as I talked a little bit earlier before, we're working on improving the update mechanisms for macOS, and that should be coming out in 2021. And then for iOS, more policies will be added throughout 2021 around through the app config deployment. And in early 2021, we'll be having CBCM integration where through app config, you'll just deploy the enrollment token like you do on desktop platforms. And then after that, then the iOS browser itself becomes managed by our console. haven't talked much about that in the previous slides, but our cloud management console allows you to set up one set of policies for all supported platforms. And that's where we see this integration for Chrome iOS being very important, as you as an administrator can configure one policy, and that would be able to be deployed on both your macOS devices, your iOS devices. And if you have to manage any of the other platforms, you'll be able to push that same policy on those platforms as well. We do support Windows and Linux as well. Thank you for listening. Give us any feedback by completing the survey and the widget using the widget below. If you have any questions related to Chrome Browser Cloud Management or anything like that, ask them below, and we'll get your email address and reach out to you if you need more information and things like that. But this is a quick cover of what we're doing to improve the user experience on Chrome on all Apple platforms. And we love working with Jamf, and we're looking forward to working more with them.